So the installation of the direct online starter motor circuit, we're going to be using singles 6491X, brown, black, grey, blue and green and yellow, CPC. And these are going to be coming from the distribution board into the starter itself. So again, leave plenty of length at the board end. And leave those for termination at a later date. So we've got the feed coming in. We're going to connect those into the incoming side of the isolation point itself. We've got L1, L2, L3 and neutral, and the CPC will go onto the outer casing of the unit. Let me tell you a little bit about the direct online starter. So what we've got here is L1, L2, L3. So this is a basic isolator. L1, L2, L3 coming in, L1, L2, L3 coming out into the top of the contactor. So L1, L2, L3. All this does is break the three conductors. What we want for this motor to be able to run is for L1, L2, L3 to become active and to become live and continuous throughout the contactor and down the SY cable. The only way we can get this to happen is by pressing the start button, which will bring in the contactor, which will then allow all three phases for the current to flow. For that contactor to come in, the starter, which is connected to, as you can see there, normally open contacts, and only when that is pressed will that energize the coil inside, which will pull in the contactor, which will allow all three line conductors for the current to come through and the motor to run. There is an auxiliary contact behind there. So when you press the start button, it doesn't hold in because the auxiliary contact at the back will hold in the contact, allowing the current to flow. How do we break that circuit then? How do we stop that current from flowing? So we've got a stop button here. This is a normally closed contact. So two terminations in the normally closed contacts. And when we press that stop button, it opens the circuit. Current therefore is not flowing and energizing the coil, which therefore releases the contact and no current therefore flows through L1, L2, L3. The overload contacts, which are at the bottom here, which I'm going to show you how to set those, normally closed also, because when there is an overload, this will become open circuit, which again will de-energize the contacts, releasing those contacts, and no current will flow from L1, L2, L3. So at the moment, I'm just showing you the connections of the incoming supply. So singles 1.5 coming in, and we're going to terminate them as so. Brown L1, black L2, grey L3, and then the blue neutral into there, and the CPC that's going to come down to the connection point at the bottom. So as we can see, the terminations now. So brown, black, grey and blue, L1, L2, L3 and neutral coming into the top, CPC going down to the side of the casing, and also the outgoing CPC coming to there also, and the backing plate is also bonded to that. The outgoing side of the direct online starter, L1, L2, L3, L1, L2, L3, going through, tie wrapping the SY cable